Hi guys, in this tutorial I am going to discussing about data transmission in CAN protocol. So CAN data transmission uses a lossless bitwise arbitration method of contention resolution. This arbitration method requires all nodes on the CAN network to be synchronized to be sampled every bit on the CAN network at the same time. This is why some call CAN synchronous. Unfortunately, the term synchronous is imprecise since the data is transmitted without a clock signal in an asynchronous format. So we know about CAN protocol. I already discussed about these CAN protocol. In that CAN protocol, we are using message priority concept. So these message priority depending upon the ID of the particular message. So in our ID concept, we have 11 bits or 29 bits in our CAN protocol. So each ID decides the priority of the message. So in our priority concept, which is the lowest value that got the highest priority. So in CAN protocol, we have two bits. These are used in our ID allocation. So we have one is dominant bit and recursive bits. Dominant bits are logical zeros and recursive bits are logical one. So we know which is the lowest priority bit that got the highest, which is the lowest value that got the highest priority. So here dominant bit is the highest priority compared to recursive bit. So we have a CAN protocol nodes. So we have two nodes. One node transmitting one bit and another node transmitting another bit. So at a time, these two nodes are transmitting bits. So one node is transmitting dominant bit and another node is transmitting recursive bit. So this time dominant bit win because the dominant bit have the highest priority. So the ideal state is represented by the recursive level. If the one node transmits the dominant bit and another node transmits the recursive bit, then there is collision and the dominant bit wins. This means there is no delay to the higher priority message, and the node transmitting the lower priority message automatically attempts to retransmit 6 bit clocks after the end of the dominant message. This makes CAN very suitable as a real-time prioritized communication system. The exact voltage for a logical 0 or 1 depending on the physical layer used. But the basic principle of the CAN requires that each node listens to the data on the CAN network, including the transmitting nodes itself. If logical 1 is transmitted by all transmitting nodes at the same time, then logical 1 is seen by all the nodes, including both the transmitting node and receiving node also. If a logical 0 is transmitted by all the transmitting nodes at the same time, then a logical 0 is seen by all nodes. If logical 0 is being transmitted by one or more nodes and logical 1 is being transmitted by one or more nodes, then logical 0 is seen by all the nodes. So this is the data transmission happening in our CAN protocol. So I will explain with example. So you can see the example here. So this is the, for example, consider the 11 bit ID CAN network with two nodes with IDs of a 15 binary representation and 16. That means 15 and node is 15 and node is 16. So here the 11 bits are the ID allocation. IDs 11 bits, each ID containing 11 bits. If these two nodes transmit at the same time, each will first transmit the start bit and then transmit the first 6 zeros of their ID with no arbitration decision begin made. So when the 7th bit ID is transmitted, the node with the ID of the 16 transmit 1 and for it ID, and the node with the ID of a 15 transmit 0 for its ID. So then what happened, we will see now. 1 minute. When this happens, the node with ID of a 16 nodes, it transmitted 1, so but sees as 0 and releases realizes that there is collision and it lost arbitration. Node 16 stopped transmitting, which allows the nodes with the ID of a 15 to continue transmission without any loss of data. Because here I am showing here picture. In that picture, we can understand using with this picture. So this is the node 15 and this is the node 16. So first of all, these two nodes transmitting start bit, then it transmitting 6 bits. So 6 bits of a ID. So after it transmitting 7th bit, so node 15 transmitting 15, that is dominant bit. Node 15 transmitting 0, that is dominant bit, and node 16 transmitting 1, that means it is a recursive bit. So comparing with the 0 and 1, so 0 has a highest priority. So here dominant bit has a highest priority. So here node 15 wins and node 16 stop transmitting data, that means transmitting IDs to the particular network. So here node 15 wins the network and node 16 stops transmitting data because node 15 have the highest priority compared with the node 16. So in that condition, node 15 wins. So this is the what happened in our data transmission in our CAN protocol. If you like this video, please click on like button and please share with your friends. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel for more video updates. Okay friends, thank you.